At last, my love has come along. My lonely days are over. A dream that I can call my own. I found a thrill to press my cheek to, a thrill that
Jaguar, Le Mans, C-types and D-types when I was a child. And I remember the pride of Jaguar winning Le Mans. I'm not even sure I knew that much what it meant at that time, but certainly it was a British car winning Le Mans. That was important.
My memories of motor racing in Jaguar really are the time, the recent times of Le Mans in the 80s, and seeing those magnificent-looking silk-cut Jaguars and the very emotional experience of seeing it go down the Mulsanne Straight for the first time.
My first memory of a Jaguar happened to be an E-Type. Bright red E-Type. It's probably, I don't know, 1961 or early 1962, and it turned the corner and my jaw just dropped. I'll never forget the moment.
I remember walking along the street and seeing this wonderful sports car with great flared wings. And I asked my father, you know, what sort of car is that? And although I didn't realise it at the time, it was actually an SS100. And he said, that's a Jaguar. And that memory sticks very clearly in my mind. And I guess my love of cars started at that moment.
Jaguar is an elegant vehicle. It's beautiful, but subtly so. It's well executed. It's understated in what it can do and how it does it.
If it had to be summed up in one word, I would say it was elegance. It says that, yes, I can do everything that is necessary to do in the world, but I shall do it in a stylish, low-key, understated, elegant manner.
Jaguars are sensuous, I think, in a way that other things are sensuous, and you want to look at them and you want to touch them and you want to look at them from different angles and you want to be in them. If you look at people going up to Jaguars, they generally go up and touch it. Quite interesting.
A Jaguar is not something that's hard-edged. It's not something that is cut. It is absolutely crafted.
There is that originality about each one, but also still that recognisability of a Jaguar.
Taking the badge off a Jaguar does not confuse anyone. They know that it's a Jaguar simply because of the flow, the sensuous nature of the styling.
In a Jaguar with a bigger capacity engine, you have a broad torque curve, so you have torque, which is what gives you that feeling of thrusting you forward, over a wide range of engine speeds, so you can put your foot in almost at any speed and get that effortless feeling of performance and power.
When we say refined power, we really mean that ability to accelerate without any need for stress or a noise. It needs to be a smooth and an effortless feeling of performance.
I think distinctive styling is really one of the fundamentals. It is the start point, I think, in any appreciation of a Jaguar.
There's a lineage right the way through, from the very early Swallows, right the way through to modern day.
It's not following current trends of other car manufacturers, or having the same car, but in four different sizes. Each car's different.
This wonderful flow of line, which is so pleasing to the eye, that you know it has been designed by somebody with great passion and flair.
The proportions of our cars tend to be quite different from many other cars on the road. Low, sleek, elegant. They are understated designs also. They are classical in nature, classical in proportion, and they are harmonious designs. Most people, including me, find that difficult to articulate, but you can see it and recognize it once you're looking at the vehicle.
I think it feels great to drive a Jaguar. The element that makes it outstanding, puts it head and shoulders above other cars, is its ride and handling.
The effortless delivery of power, the wonderful suspension system, the sense of being always in control. There's a sense of security about what the car is going to do in any conditions.
Through the soles of your feet, through the seat, through the steering wheel, you know you're in a car that will accept any road condition with great ease.
The amount of effort that goes into the preparation of the veneers, the bonding of the veneers to the birchwood base, the French polishing, which is done by cabinet makers, really, and the installation, it oozes luxurious craftsmanship.
It's an intimate environment. You feel part of the environment of the car. We also put a heavy emphasis on using natural colors, textures, grains, to give a natural feel to the whole of the interior of the car.
Jaguars are more reliable today than they've ever been, simply because we have set out to make them more reliable than they have ever been. In every way we've gone about, every element of designing the car, manufacturing the car, we've gone out of our way to ensure that we've designed and manufactured reliability into the car, just as we've designed and manufactured quality into the car.
If I've got a problem with a fault of the car, I can get quality involved. Whoever, I've got backup from whoever I need. If need be, I've got the power to stop the track if it's a quality issue.
We feel we're building a good car, well, the best car in the world, and that reflects in the morale on the shop floor.
You say you must never ever forget that what we're designing a car for is not to sell the first time, but to be a treasured item when it's sold the third, the fourth time, and then eventually becomes a classic.
I think a Jaguar owner expects to be treated in the same way that he appreciates the car, in that the car is distinctive and individual.
Occasionally you bump into people and out of interest you'll ask them, what do you think of your Jaguar? And they'll look at you all straight and you just say to them, well, I work there, I'd just like a bit of feedback and so I can get a personal feel as to how you feel for a car that I've produced.
A very important part of being a Jaguar owner is that very close relationship he has with his dealer, and the way he's treated when he goes to the dealer to make him feel special. Owning a Jaguar is a very special experience.
Jaguars today are without a doubt the safest Jaguars that have ever been built. We have every cutting edge feature in the car that provides our customers with the assurance that they're going to get protected in the unlikely event that they get into any trouble on the road. We of course have all the deformable structures in the car, we have the airbags, and of course we have side beams and non-damage bumpers.
The advances in technology and safety have to be made by all manufacturers as customers' expectations grow. What we've tried to do at Jaguar is do those in an original way, come out with something new, and then they become things which contribute to the safety of the car, to the safety of the driving.
I believe that Jaguar is going to succeed in the future because it has a tremendous family, a great group of people, team of people all wanting to work together. And not just the team within Jaguar working together, with all the dealers and with a tremendous following out in the marketplace of people that also want Jaguar to succeed.
We have three brand new cars, XJ, XK, S-Type. I am busy working on the fourth brand new car, X400. So the growth within this organization is extremely apparent to me because it tends to start with styling.
I think Jaguars are, were, will be a copy of nothing, because what we're doing is designing cars for people who are themselves a copy of nothing. Our clientele really wants something that expresses their individuality. If we gave them what everybody else provides, we wouldn't be here, and we shouldn't be.
Cheek to a thrill that I